ಮರೆಯುನೀನೆ ನನ್ನ ಗುರಿಯು ನೀನೆ ಗಾಳಿಯು ನೀನೆ ನನ್ನ ಗುರಿಯು ನೀನೆ ನೀನೇ ನನ್ನ ವಶ ನಾನು ಸ್ವವಶ ನೀನೇ ನನ್ನ ವಶ ನನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀನು ನಿನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಬೇಡ ಹೃದಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರಿವುದು ನೋಡುವುದು ಮಾಡುವುದು ನೀನೇ ನಾನೆಂಬುವುದು ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿತ್ತ ನಿನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ನನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀನು ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಬೇರ ಹೃದಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರಿವುದು ಆನಂದದಲ್ಲಿ ಆನಂದ ನನ್ನ ಸ್ವಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುವೇ ನನ್ನ ಹೃದಯ ಸಿಂಹಾಸನದಲ್ಲಿ ನುಡಿದು ಕುಳಿತು ನುಡಿದು ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ನೀಡು ನಿನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ನನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀನು ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಬೇಡ ಶಿಕ್ಷೆ ನನಗೆ ಬೇಡ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ನನಗೆ ಬೇಡ ಶಿಷ್ಯ ಗುಣ ತುಂಬಿದರೆ ಸಾಕು ನೀನೇ ಗುರು ವಂದನೆ ಅನೇಕ ಕೋಟಿ ರಮಾಯ ರಾಮಭದ್ರಾಯ ರಾಮಚಂದ್ರಾಯ ವೀರಸೇ ರಘುನಾಥಾಯ ನಾಥಾಯ ಸೀತಾಯ ಹದಯೇ ನಮಃ ಸೀತಾಯ ಓಕೇ ಓಕೇ ರೂಪಂ ಚಾಲು ಚಾಲು ನಿಸ್ಸಾರಮು ಸರ್ವಸಾರಮು ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ನಾಮಮು ನಾಮಮು ನೀ ದಿವ್ಯ ನಾಮಮು ಶ್ರೀರಾಮುನಿ ನಾಮಮು ಭಾರತ కృష్ణాయ
కృష్ణాయ
వాసుదేవాయ
వాసుదేవాయ
దేవకి నందనాయక నందగోప కుమారాయ
కుమారాయ
గోవిందాయ
గోవిందాయ
సింహవాహిని
नारायणी motivated or what can be lived with is where all the problems and solutions are about in this world. Are you catching? It's a very difficult topic for few, but it's quite simple like this. I'll try to tell you, there are only two things, base things in the whole world. Mind with fear. Mind seeking pleasure. I don't want to say happiness, because happiness is the state of mind. It's not in anything. You eat gulab jamun, it's not. Tomorrow they will say diabetes. That is the state of fear, this is the state of pleasure means. I can only put it as pleasure. Money, over money means someone else is eyeing on me, some problems are there. So that's also not pleasure, but that's only a pleasure, but not happiness. But the world runs through all this as if there is a happiness in all this. Maybe things because of the input through various sources, media, newspapers, behavior of your friends and other civilized and developed people, so-called. So if you analyze, from your mind only you can express all this. The mind which is static, mind which is by itself is happy. The intellect which does not analyze, which takes, accepts, is blissful. The other things are in the analytical state and in the feeling state. You understand this? So the feeling state, the mind has only two things, the feeling of fear, feeling seeking pleasure. So what is being played in this world, I was clearly telling you, is these two feelings only. Not anything which you are trying, but don't confuse it with specialty. Specialty is trying to be with your state. It's not analysis, it's not feeling. There once again we may fail if we are mixing these two. That's where the other things come, like surrender, faith, so many other things. Whereas here it's only these two, fear and seeking pleasure. Right? Now, why this fear is there? Because of the input we have received from various places. The feeling of fear, very important, starts with each step in your life. Because we seek pleasure, so there is a risk of not getting pleasure. So that is the fear. You understand this? So, pleasure may be getting a toy for a child, or going for a play, anything in this world, right from morning, getting toothpaste to night. It is just a movement towards what we think that's a pleasure. And because we may not get it, that is the inherent, the doubt we have got, that results in fear. Then fear starts, once the fear starts, the stress develops. Very important. These are all maybe the world of psychological terms, maybe, we don't know. If you refer to psychologists, parapsychology, you may know. The stress develops from where? So, March 31st is exam, the stress starts today. The exam may be nothing for the examiner, but for me it's important. So the stress starts. And immediately the stress builds up into what? Anxiety. Then anxiety results in depression. What are the three things I saw?
When we seek pleasure, we fear that we will not get it. And that is where fear starts. Then fear leads to stress. Stress leads to anxiety, and anxiety leads to depression.
Anxiety leads to depression. This is all right. These are all normal things, everyday things in each one's life, they say. For me, I don't know. But this depression should not increase to different levels. Even today, you see that a person getting depressed, they get 4 days, 5 days to come over a small depressed mood. They grow beard, they go here, there. Women will be introverts. They will be showing eyes full of tears. Something like that. So the depressed mood itself is consuming all your time. There's no time for all this, if you really understand. Otherwise, this depression goes on. This is a very mild form of mental trying to get balance. I want to correct imbalance. Then comes a different term, it's called phobia. Phobia is what your input you receive in various places, during various moments of your life where you receive messages. Not all the words are going into your ears. Suppose you go to the river, your mummy says, don't go, the river is getting flooded. So don't beware of the flood. And anywhere you see in TV flood, you will start shivering. And if you go near the river itself, you will be afraid. So this what you call?
Phobia.
Aerophobia or any other phobia will come. This is the secondary form of aggressive depression or expansive depression or what you call, once the depression increases itself, it becomes phobia. But this depression is left out because automatically you get afraid because of the input we have received. Suppose this man has killed someone, suppose someone says, whenever I see that phobia, that mind comes, if this man has killed someone, then I am afraid. So I keep myself distant or I facing that issue. So this phobia also is a state of mind where it is through the inputs at various levels. It may be today, this moment, or it may be from the back of my memory. Then comes, all of a sudden, you have seen something which you have not accepted, which is happening to you. Understand, suppose I want first rank and I get last rank. This kind of sudden shock is called schizophrenic tendencies. This is very difficult to come over because we are always reminded of this. I have lost, this world has cheated me. I have lost this world. It's a little more serious than phobia. Phobia at least we can, if I fall into water with something which can prevent me from getting drowned. Or something like that. Any phobia can be overcome immediately by facing it, by reacting to it. Whereas this tendency called the schizophrenic tendencies take a little more longer time because it's already there, something happens, which very rarely it happens actually. But once it happens, we don't forget it. We are afraid of it and many more times we are thinking of it. And any situations, we will be going on repeating, oh no, no, I know. The entire thing is being hated, or the entire thing is being remembered, because something has happened, some unexpected thing to the life of a person. Once it grows to more, then only the tendency is called the real madness. So I am talking about who is sane, who is insane. The levels I was trying to tell. The minor insanity can be fear. Just from fear. Fearing of fear. Fearing of fear itself is the minor starting point. Don't call it mental aberration, whatever you want to say. Little. The maximum mental madness is, suppose you have come and dashed against foot or some wall suddenly. Police have taken note of it because the cycle is cracked, something like that. Then police is running towards you. At that moment you are breathless, rather it's a word, but you don't have any thought. You are stunned. That stunning can reach you to balancing or madness. That moment of getting stunned, shocked totally, without any consciousness, without anything, that can result, if you collect yourself, then you can even collect, get your release, whatever you call, liberation from thinking itself. Otherwise what happens is, the more long you are stunned and you are want to come back, getting afraid of things, then that is where the mental imbalance starts. We call it madness in the general term, we won't call them. It's a little insanity. This is where people call them possessed by devils, possessed by this so-called many things. And also people who are irregular, with irregular behavior, like to different levels. More you sedate them with medicines, more they are with aberrations. This is called mental imbalance, which was called hysteria once upon a time. It was called hysteria once upon a time. In the psychological levels. So now, this is the maximum range of man's insanity, where he can go to any extent, and even the law book tries to give a little more interest to such people who are mad. Oh, let them be pardoned. Their punishment will be little less in the state of man. But whether it's pardonable or not, it depends upon justice and judicial people. But why I'm saying this is where we are, we can now, in the worldly frame, we can take a look and we can just be aware. Then the other positive point is for pleasure. It's positive because once you feel for it, in a positive way, it won't result in fear. I am going to get it. Suppose I am getting engaged to a girl. I may not expect fear, you know, immediately. I'll be a little more trying to be happy. I may try to expect something, some pleasure in the ceremonies, in this, in that, in being together. So this is where the positive pleasure point starts. This is a substitute in the mental level for feeling of fear. This pleasure also, once you get more, the stress is called anxiety, once again. The pressure also results in anxiety. When? Anxious moments. Suppose you are very fond of village or your city you like. The more you come here, you get a lot of restlessness. So, full of pressure only, you are going to expect a lot of things. After waiting, we will see. But during the cold, this expectation of pleasure itself results in some kind of anxiety. Then once you meet there, this is, there is no stress, depression or any other thing. Either you get null and void because things don't happen as in any level. Or once it happens more, it's called, instead of phobia, it's called mania. What's it called? Mania is where you are in the whole group of bhajans, or in the song level, or somewhere in the group, or even alone, when you get very ecstatic, with full of happiness, you forget the world. It's a chemical change in the body, that's called mania. And whoever is always showing happiness always, is always in the other stream of hysteric pleasure, what you call that. Extreme madness of pleasure. So in both levels there is a little insanity because mind only plays with all this. So beware, when you are dealing with life, these two are bound to happen. So I was trying to teach you why we have named our program as relaxation and awareness. If we can relax and be aware, then these two can be controlled. Otherwise, if these two only you want, either pleasure for creativity, or getting stressed because of the creativity and activity, you are getting stressed and depressed. These two are going to be balancing each other. That is the base of our life. So we have to relax somewhere. Then we have to be aware that what we are doing is right or wrong or whatever we want. We want this pleasure or we can feel this fear. If we are aware of that, then we are in control of all the situations. So, relax from there. Happiness is a state of mind. It is not, it cannot, nothing in the world can give you happiness. It can give you a very ecstatic mania or pleasurable ecstasy, you can call. But happiness is a different state where yesterday a boy was celebrating birthday, he came to me. And he is studying in a very important school, Bishop Cut. And he is totally introvert, so his mother was telling. Oh, Bishop Kadam Bhai is introvert. And he asked him, "Are, don't you meet friends? Are you not sociable?" No, I don't have any friends. So in that school, you don't have, it's in a very important road and all the civilized people are getting their children educated there. You don't have any friends there. I'm not talking about the school, sorry. But in a very important school, in a very, very important road and where only people of high should shine. And this boy is telling, "I don't have any friends." I asked him, then he told, because his mother told that he is becoming an introvert, or he is an introvert, some word she was. He told, yes, occasionally I have one friend, but I don't have any friends, sir. I don't socialize with anyone. Why? Why you want to be like this? Then he told a very nice sentence. Why? A very small why. He gave a very nice reply. Because all others do what I don't like. I only can do what I like. Understand this? A very great revelation at that age. So think of this, if a boy can reach, why not we? We will control, we will be in the shukratan, we will be in anywhere, but we will be alone and happy. This doesn't come in psychological level. If anyone says that feeling total within is anything connected with psychological imbalance, is wrong. What the entire world seeks is this type of static happiness and pleasure. All other things are in mobile world, with movement and creativity on the one side, it can be effects, ill effects of creativity on the other side. So think about this, and it's important for our life. So when you put it in the education program, the different levels of mind, how people deal with everything in the world is answered in this, either this or that, and how we have to be, so that we are in the moment, but not of it. We are in the moment, but not of it. Thank you. How much importance, why money is required, that's my question. Suppose for a person, sky is the limit. Anything, sky only is the limit. But if you know your limitations, then you will be aware of where we have to challenge these limitations and where we have to accept these limitations. So, so important. In many places, instead of answering things like this, you know your limitations, then where we can challenge our limitations, we can challenge and accept. Where we have to accept our limitations, we have to accept it. Understand? So money for what is the question. How much money means for each one it is different. For a Bahadur, a Chaukidar, why should be always a watchman in the house? I may require a house. Maybe that is his money. For a corporate king, maybe for the number one rich man I have to become. That is his, maybe that is his limit of his understanding of money. So where money plays, it depends upon each one's wishes. But what happens is, where India teaches you that this much will be given to you, if you have already done this much. To understand this, then we will not question anything in life. We will accept it. But whenever we want also, if we desire for the total happiness or bliss or realization, all other things will be added to us without our seeking. There is a secret in life, that's all. We will not seek it, but we will not be complete without it, because God knows it. Suppose someday, that's what one saint was, famous saint was telling. One man was highly appreciated in Malaysia. And he was revered. He was a normal householder, he was revered, he was going and many people started prostrating. This man was going and saying, this man, what do you call, is getting high reveration. One day I should accept this person in Malaysia. He just thought and left the thought. And he started dwelling, he joined some mission, went for studies of Vedic literature and all. After he came back, a big house was given to him, and a mission was started, the branch was started in his name, rather he headed. Then, what Malaysia, whole Bangalore started attending his lectures and etc. Then he was telling me, oh, this was just in my thought, and I never recovered. After so many days, I thought that whoever prostrated before this old man came to me, and much more, the whole Bangalore comes and prostrates before me. And I knew the power of God. If we work for God, things are easier. If I would have worked for getting this revelation through crooked means, maybe I'll be cheating myself and the world will be cheating. Understand, this is a very secretive formula. Still world is not revealing this, because they just don't know. They don't want to know, I don't know. Anywhere, you aim for high things, lower things will fall at your feet. If you aim for lower things, I always say, hardest of the hardest problems should be solved with simple solutions. Simplest of the simpler problems can never be solved. It will take a lot of time for them getting irritated. For what? Who knows? It will take a lot of time. But a little more irritation is anger. That can be solved. The more aggressive anger, it can be solved like this. Even nursing was killing or very miserable. One shloka and that fellow melts. Understand that? But small thing takes later. This world has not known and received this message. Smallest problems are the hardest to solve. And hardest problems will be solved like this. People confuse that hardest problems require more hard solutions. It will take a lot of time. No. This is where when great people like in Gita and all said, it's here and now. The self-realization is here and now. That is what they mean. They don't want you to waste the life. It's here and now. It's here and now. Every second. Small problems should not be. He talks to public, go there, here. He behaves normally because he is normal, innocent. But more we are going to try to teach him protocol, more we are going to try to teach him about the value of his life, and his importance of his life, and how many enemies can be created. At each point, he should only see here and there, he should not go here, there. Suppose we try to teach him, he gets polluted. Stupid society. Then, now, whether he is a king or on the road or getting elected or not, it doesn't matter. He moves, the king moves. But if you are trying to teach sanity, civilization, and in the name of all this, fear in him, then next time it will be a problem. Where should I sit? What should I eat? He wants to eat with the public. And the king's role makers say, no, you have to sit only with important people in that particular room. That is already security proof. Security proof or foolproof? Foolproof security. Both ways. Then this simple person has to go and dine with whomever he does not like. So this is where the pollution is. Yes, be normal, innocent in all the situations. Don't accept all these rules. That's all for big people. We will not behave abnormally or childishly. Childlike we are, we will keep that. And we will not disturb them. Neither we allow ourselves to be disturbed. If that state is maintained, Raja or Braja, the person is an innocent Balaka. Means is God man. If we are going to be afraid or ecstatic, then it's a shame on the society. I can't blame anyone. The Raja. The society does not allow me. Even God pardons all the people, otherwise everyone will be killed. My promise is that no one will can face time or that. If God is allowed, but He Himself pardons, gives more life, gives more strength, gives more energy, for the person to go up to any limits till he himself is aware. Till such a time, you will only read Vedas, Upanishads, this religion, that religion, everything will not change. And he is thinking that is that. So, no one can change anyone, but input can be given. But if seriously one thinks about it, the time itself in the form of God, Guru, however it is, helps. And they are the totality. They don't have anything called the time space. So they are not even the body. Such people are such deities whom you believe in, if you are aligned, then it's a different thing. Till such a time it's going on. Either in fear or seeing pleasure, as good question, sir. Two words, anyone can summarize and tell us? Two words means 3-4 sentences. Two words means thank you. But it's not full mind. It's only a feeling I was trying to tell. It's a feeling of, I was very careful in using the word. Feeling part of the mind is feeling pleasure or feeling fear, but the state of mind is happiness.
Like you said,
my name can be Vishwanath and I can sign as Vishwanath, but I'm not. It is bliss.
Otherwise, you are going on energizing, that's not
bliss. That is to, as I put it, naiti, naiti. To come to that point of... There is no answer, you know. Till you get answer, it's only in the analytical state. Enquiry, deeper contemplation. Very nice. You can look static, but you won't be. Yes, it's still going on, you know. Sometimes some open ones also, when they sit. They look static, but they are not. They can throw anyone, they can call and get up. That's the answer. Right? What is the difference between hand and its? Not the palm, the lines in the palm. The impressions results in feelings. Whereas hand is the mind. There are impressions. Like these impressions are there in the mind. Which results, this, if this can result in fate, what is going to happen to you? This can result in your physical activities. Thinking, feeling, doing. So that is the difference. What is the difference between hand and lines? Of course, there is no line. There is no difference. If you say there is only an impression. Pressure, not pressure. The impressions results in a particular type of feeling, fear or pressure. Each one differs in that. So the impressions are like these lines. Impressions, you call it as vasanas, whatever you want to call it. Tendency to feel fear. Isn't it? You are at liberty, but be in the state of happiness or bliss. And all other things can be looked at with ease. Don't tell me it's difficult, easy, because we can't question it. For everyone, something is difficult, something is. For this, why doctor exam is difficult? For a doctorate, something else is difficult. Getting Nobel is difficult. That is all in the mind. There is no solution for this question. Whether it is difficult, certain situation is difficult. There is no answer to this, because we don't want answers, that's it. Real answer. I often quote this example. My grandmother, whom you saw on Friday, she is so active, she cooks for all, she feeds, and she sits down and does puja, and she sits down and eats food, and she... All those things she does. When someone asks, so why you... this thing means, she gives the solution for the entire life immediately.
when I received my diksha from my guru, that means already she is going to be mentally stable. So she is going to receive mantra from the guru, from the faith that guru's mantra will annihilate all other damn things. So with that faith, she is receiving mantra. She gave promise, pratijna to guru. What is that pratijna to guru? Then she says that, as long as I am aware, I am conscious, I will cook and eat my own food, I will clean all my vessels, and wherever I eat, I will put gomayam. I have to go search for cow dung and clean it. All cow dung I have to buy, someone has to give me, I will clean it. Then I will wash my clothes by myself, as long as I am conscious. And as long as I am conscious, I will spread my own bed. What is the rest of the time? After cooking, after eating, after laying bed, after washing. Only sometime. There she does her Guru's mantra. Understand? The whole life's problem is solved. Whenever she wants to interact, she interacts smilingly, angrily, with notes. The same thing immediately she will change. So she will say it will run. Oh, from that language it is right, but still this may be wrong from this angle. She is not bothered by the angles. She will only suggest. Suddenly she will become over-money. Over-money means as if in the ta words, never she allows another to touch her. It is a different thing. Because of her thinking. And it's also better, you know, to leave her by herself. Suddenly she will tell that, everyone is man only, so all are eligible. Suddenly she will come to that point. So both she is just telling. Why she wants to retain, she doesn't want to tell out. Understand? For nice interaction purposes, all those things she creates. The same opinion she will tell, and immediately she will look from this angle and say that that's also right. I was telling this because of this person. So, what I am trying to tell is, it is not the body. Even if she is going to suffer a bodily with pain and all, which she does, she will never tell out that there is a pain in the body. More she is painful and whatever, feverish, she will not tell, she will close to the top end. That is the sign that she doesn't want to tell outside or get disturbed. But still someone will come and tell her. Immediately she will remove and sit down. No one at that age will say, sit down and talk to her. She will immediately rise like a bow, she will rise and sit and talk, and then once again. What I am saying is, see, the whole conscious is a beautiful word she used. Nanna prajna irukkara varaikum, I have done pratijna to guru. As long as I am conscious, I have done pratijna to my guru. That means that her hands have to work, her mind has to work. All the time she is awake, these two have to work. So that looks after the world. The rest is God. That she does by mantra. Isn't that a good solution? So if she says that, suppose I become incapacitated, I will allow others to do, that she has not given promise. As long as I am conscious, that makes her work. So look at her body, she is not even one kuchi of broomstick. There is no nothing inside. And head to toe operated. And pleurisy, this, that, whatever, we can't imagine all the diseases. Never she complains till today, even then also. When she was suffering also, she will not show a slightest feeling in the eyes. Even when she moves with her two hands, with pleurisy, she will not show that worrying. She will go cook, feed others, call everyone kings, queens, Vadarani, Vadaraja, but these people will be looking and getting shocked because a lot of worms will be moving around, what you call wound. Scarecrows, you know, that kind of disease also she suffered. Never. Her helpful tendency goes on till today. Till today she feeds people. She cooks for herself and cooks for others also in home. So that means that only that will, not even willpower, it's a super power to act. willingness to undergo all these things, at the same time willingness to express our activities and feelings at our command. That comes only with healthy conscious feeling. And if this can be adopted in our life, I think it solves the entire problems of our life. It's no imposition, but it's a good thought at least, you know, to grasp. It will help us once we grow old and all. When we feel pain, we can remember this. I am conscious of my pain, so I will start acting, no problem. As long as I am conscious, I will not accept the defeat. It's a good sign. Today, I think we are dealt in depth.